Hi, I'm Alexis Oman, and I'm an associate curator and zooarchaeologist here at Jamestown Rediscovery. And today we're going to be talking about animal bones because we recently received a grant from the Conservation Fund to conduct a study about our second well here at Jamestown. It had a 5 by 5 foot square base, and the identification of faunal material can be quite a long process, and even more so with a large assemblage. This assemblage, we have currently estimated it at 90 to 100,000 bones, and so as you can imagine, that takes a long time. So we're doing a multi-phase process to start organizing them by certain categories so that it's easier for our faunal analysts to do with their comparative collection by the very end of the final phase. So we've had volunteers do rough sorts of the bones, with things that are easily recognizable. So we have a lot of pig mandibles and maxilla with teeth in them, certain long bones, vertebrae like these. So we have some rough categories that are easily recognizable. And then, since I have a background in zooarchaeology, I do a bit of a finer sort and review what they have pre-sorted, so making sure things are in the right place, so that when we do send them to the zooarchaeologist that we work with, which is Susan Andrews, Steve Atkins, and Joanne Bowen, they will be able to do the final identifications, because those final IDs require what's called a comparative collection, which is a full collection of skeletons, literally skeletons in their closet, that you can be able to hold up fragments of bone like this and match it to an exact species, hopefully. Sometimes you can't get it down to the exact species if you only have small bits that aren't very easily identifiable. Sometimes you can only call them medium bird or large bird instead of a narrower category. Something they'll also do is look for things like cut marks, which we have on this bone here and this bone here, and that can give evidence about how an animal was butchered. We also will keep track of other evidence like burning, which is in this tray here. And all of this will go into a final report that will generate things like species lists, which is just a full comprehensive list of everything that's been identified at this particular context. It will be able to tell you things like relative abundance, which is just the ratios if you have a lot of fish or maybe a lot of pig compared to other animals. So reports can also include age profiles, and teeth are particularly useful for that. So for example, we have some pig teeth here, and this one is showing one of the permanent teeth in the process of erupting, while this one is showing what it looks like when it's fully erupted, and is even showing evidence of some slight wear on this side, and you can see these other teeth have significant wear to them. So that's very useful to have that data to include. And all of this goes into a large report that will also integrate the additional archaeological evidence we have for this context, as well as accessory historical evidence as well. So that's what all goes into the mega report at the end. So we're looking forward to seeing the results of the study, and please stay tuned for more updates. Thanks.